In this video, we're continuing on with the multiplying special case polynomials worksheet on the CUDA software website under the Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Now remember, the special cases are a minus b times a plus b that quantity squared, or a minus b that quantity squared. In number 13, you can see that we have a plus b times a minus b. That's going to be equal a squared minus b squared. Our a in this case is 3, and our b is the quantity 7b squared. So for a squared minus b squared, we're plugging in 3 for a, so that will be 3 squared minus 7b squared, and that quantity squared, because that is b. 3 squared is 9, and we're subtracting 7b squared, which is 7 squared times b to the fourth, which is 49v to the fourth. So 9 minus 49v to the fourth is our solution in number 13. In number 14, again, we have a minus b times a plus b, which is the same as a plus b times a minus b. So we're going to have a squared minus b squared. Our a in this case is 7b squared, and our b is 6. So plugging 7b squared in for a, we'll get 7b squared minus b, which is 6 squared. 7b squared is 49b to the fourth, and we're subtracting 6 squared, which is 6 times 6, or 36. So 49b to the fourth minus 36. In number 15, a plus b squared. So that's going to be a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. A is equal to 2, and b is equal to v. So plugging 2 in for a, we'll get 2 squared plus 2 times 2, and plugging v in for b times v plus v squared. So 2 squared is 4, plus 2 times 2 times v, which is 2 times 2, which is 4 times v, which is 4v, plus v squared. 4 plus 4v plus v squared. In number 16, we have a plus b times a minus b. So that's going to give us a squared minus b squared. Our a is 6v, and our b is 3. So plugging 6v in for a, we'll get 6v squared minus b squared, which is 3 squared. 6v squared is 6 squared times v squared, which will be 36v squared minus 3 squared, which is 9. We have to remember to distribute that squared to both the 6 and the v, not just the v. That's why the answer in number 16 is 36v squared minus 9. And number 17, a minus b times a plus b. So our a is 8a squared, and our b is 2. Plugging 8a squared in for a, we'll get 8a squared plus 2 squared. 8a squared is 8a squared times 8a squared, which is 64a to the fourth, and we're adding that to 2 squared, which is 4. So 64a to the fourth plus 4 is our solution in number 17. In number 18, a plus b squared is going to equal a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So a is 4a, and b is 7. Plugging 4a in for a, we'll get 4a, and that quantity squared, plus 2 times 4a times b, which is 7, plus b squared, which is 7 squared. 4a squared is 4a times 4a, which is 16a squared, and we're adding that to 2 times 4, which is 8 times 7 will be 56 times a, plus 7 squared, which is 49. So 16a squared plus 56a plus 49. Number 19, a minus b squared. That's a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, where a is 2 in and b is 7. So plugging 2 in for a, we'll get 2 in that quantity squared minus 2 times 2 in times our b, which is 7, plus b squared, which will be 7 squared. 2 in squared is 2 in times 2 in, which is 4 in squared, and we're subtracting 2 times 2 in, which is 4 in, times 7, which is 28 in. And we're adding that to 7 squared, which is 49. 4 in squared minus 28 in plus 49. A plus b times a minus b, so our a is negative m, and our b is 5 in. Negative m squared minus 5 in squared. Negative m times negative m is a positive m squared, and we're subtracting 5 in squared, which is 5 in times 5 in, which is 25 in squared. M squared minus 25 n squared is the solution in number 20. Our a in number 21 is 7u. Our b is 4b. So that means a squared minus b squared will be 7u, that quantity squared, minus 4v, and that quantity squared. 7u times 7u is going to be 49 u squared, and we're subtracting 4v times 4v, which is 16v squared. So 49u squared minus 16v squared. Our a in number 22 is negative y, and our b in number 22 is 3x. So a squared is negative y, or the opposite of y, squared, and we're subtracting b squared, which is 3x, and that quantity squared. Negative y times negative y is going to equal y squared, and we're subtracting 3x times 3x, which is 9x squared. Y squared minus 9x squared is our solution in number 22. A squared minus 2ab plus b squared. For number 23, our a is 9x squared, and our b is 10y. So plugging negative 9x squared in for a, we'll get negative 9x squared squared minus 2 times negative 9x squared times 10y, since 10y is b, plus b squared, which is 10y squared. Negative 9x squared squared is negative 9x squared times negative 9x squared, which is going to be a positive 81, and that's x to the fourth, since negative 9 times negative 9 is 81, and x squared times x squared is x to the fourth. So then we're going to subtract. In this next step, I'm going to combine negative 2, negative 9, and 10, since everything's being multiplied together. 2 times negative 9 is negative 18, times 10 is negative 180. However, subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. So as opposed to subtracting a negative 180 times what's left, which is x squared times y, we're going to actually add a positive 180 times x squared times y. And then we're going to add that to 10y squared, which is 10 times 10 times y, which is 100y squared. So 81x to the fourth plus 180x squared times y plus 100y squared. And number 24, a is going to be 4u, and b is 9v. Plugging 4u in for a, we'll get 4u, that quantity squared, plus 2 times 4u, times b, which is 9b, plus b squared, which is the squared. 4u squared is 16u squared. And we're adding that to 2 times 4, which is 8, times 9, which is 72, times u, times v, so 72uv, plus 9v squared, which is 81v squared. 16u squared plus 72 times u times v plus 81v squared. Our a in number 25 is 7u, and our b is 6v. Plugging a in, we'll get 7u, that quantity squared, and we're subtracting b squared, which will be 6v, and that quantity squared. 7u squared is 49u squared, and we're subtracting 6v squared, which is 36v squared. So 49u squared minus 36v squared. And lastly, number 26. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up. So for 26, we have a minus b and that quantity squared. So that's a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. A is equal to this quantity, negative 6x. B is equal to the quantity 7y squared. So plugging negative 6x in for a and 7y squared in for b, we'll get negative 6x squared minus 2 times negative 6x times 7y squared plus 7y squared squared. Negative 6x squared is going to be a positive 36x squared. And we're subtracting 2 times negative 6 times 7. So 2 times negative 6 is negative 12. And negative 12 times 7 is negative 84. But since we're subtracting a negative, that's the same as adding a positive 84, and we're still multiplying that to x and then y squared. And lastly, we'll add 7y squared squared, which will be 49y to the fourth. 36x squared plus 84xy squared plus 49y to the fourth. That's our final solution on the multiplying special case polynomials worksheet. If you have any questions, leave a comment and I'll respond as soon as I can. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. All subscriptions and likes are greatly appreciated, and let me know that you're finding these videos helpful. And when you subscribe to my channel, you'll be updated when I come out with new videos, which will be helpful for you.